What's happening? It's Jareth, back at it with some Marvel Snap content, and today we need an emergency meeting. There is a new patch that has just dropped into Marvel Snap. July 19th, 2022 patch is what we are looking at. So in today's video, we're going to be going through a few different things. One being looking over these patch notes. What changes are you guys going to be seeing in these most next couple of days? We'll also be looking at some card adjustments, as there were some pretty significant buffs and or nerfs depending on how you're looking at it. So we'll be giving you a breakdown of what those buffs and nerfs look like and where we think the state of the game is going to move from there. And lastly, we do have the new Nexus event has just been added to Marvel Snap. So very interesting the way they are kind of working this out. It is over in the shop. And in this Nexus event, we are featured the Mighty Thor, Jane Foster. So we'll be checking her out and opening quite a few of the Nexus event cubes in order to show you guys what to expect in these Nexus events moving forward and just some overall adjustments and whatnot. So let's go ahead and move on over to the patch notes. So July 19th, 2022 patch is what we are looking at. So we'll give you guys the brief highlights so you can initially kind of see what we are expecting here. And we'll kind of give you a full breakdown again of some of those card changes, both in-game and the Nexus event. So new Nexus event is here. Limited time events that offer new cards, variants, avatars, and more. Nexus events are available in that shop and can be purchased with gold. So kind of nice for some of you free-to-play players out there. If you are able to conserve some of your gold, you can potentially open some of these Nexus event contents. So also updates to the weekly missions. So complete overhaul, we'll get into that a little bit more. And a pretty significant change to the collection progression. So made some adjustments for everybody just to hopefully alleviate some of the card progression. I believe their thoughts are to allow people to get more cards more often. Once you reach 1,000 plus in your collection power, it really starts to slow down. So they're making some adjustments there, and we'll get into that for you guys here as well. So firstly, again, that Nexus event. So we'll be heading over to the shop. So stay tuned to the later bits of this video, and we'll give you guys a full breakdown there. So a general breakdown, we're looking at collector's caches. So changing card and mystery rewards in the collection road to collection level 500 plus, the collection caches and collections reserve caches. These will cause players to significantly get more gold variants, as well as doubling pace of the card rewards above that 1,500 collection level. So a little bit more what we're looking at. We got some card emojis. So I know we like to see some of those, especially when our opponents play something and we're like, what just happened? So it might be fun to do something a little different with those card emojis. We have card upgrade visuals. So I know there's a couple different characters they added some voice lines to, as well as when you're upgrading some cards, the look and feel has been significantly changed. Season cash, level 51 and above, you can get those contents. All right, so some of this other stuff is just pretty straightforward. So let's go ahead and move on into this mission category. So if you guys are playing pretty consistently, the missions are a lot of the time pretty easy to achieve. So, but for those of you who can't, you know, regularly play this game and you're more checking in throughout the day, or maybe just a few times in a week, this is hopefully allowing you to meet your daily missions. So 35 daily missions in a week should be nice. Gives us a nice fancy UI upgrade, looks a lot better for us. Can get this extra mission refresh up to 3 times a day. That's, you know, if necessary, you know, you missed a few days playing the game, you're on vacation or something, you can utilize some gold to make sure you're keeping up on that season pass. So, you know, a little bit better UI looks here as well. So not too bad. Again, those art effects, you know, we got Blue Marvel, Doctor Strange, a couple others. I'll let you guys see those in the game. So We are heading over to the card. So I gave you a little sneak peek as we kept scrolling down. We're gonna get you over to the card adjustment section. I wanted to give you guys a full breakdown in game, what that looks like and what decks that are being affected because of these nerfs and buffs. So let's get you over to that card progression side. We'll see you over there, guys. All right, guys, continuing our patch breakdown, our emergency meeting, we are looking at the card adjustment section right now. So as you can see, we're going to start off with a one I wasn't really expecting, but maybe one that was much needed, the one we didn't expect. So America Chavez has been adjusted. She is now at this 6 mana, 9 power play. So our developers felt that America Chavez seeing such high amounts of play and in pretty much any assortment of decks, as you guys can imagine, especially early on, such a staple as being able to draw her always on turn 6 brings a lot of potential for us. So seeing that adjustment, we are, I believe, gonna expect to see some changes, especially into the, you know, drop your hand on turn 6 and make it happen even better with Sif and Ghost Rider. So some adjustments there as well, but America Chavez being our first one that has some adjustments. So being 9 power compared to 10, I believe she'll still be slotted in quite a bit, and just because she does help you draw the cards you're looking for earlier on and then make sure you get some power on turn 6. So we'll be a interesting adjustment I think we'll see as the game progresses. So next one on the list, we have Crossbones. So not really much of an adjustment, changed the wording a little bit better, so made it a lot more clear what we can expect with this guy. Unfortunately, he is still just not much of a playable character, so maybe that will change in the near future if they do decide to make that happen, but still pretty low on the curve as far as a tier 3 card unlock is. Next on our list, we have Ebony Maw. So Ebony Maw was made adjusted to 1 mana, 6 power. He is now at this 1 mana, 7 power. So a lot of the times when you draw this guy before turn 3, you're kind of wondering, how am I going to play him out, as you can't play cards here after he's played. So there are some combos maybe you could do with Ebony Maw and Viper. You know, give them Ebony Maw so they can't play anything on that section. Or you could play 0 and make it so, you know, 2 mana, you're getting 7, 8, 9, 10 power with 0 and Ebony Maw. So we might see something like that creep into the meta, especially if some Destroyer sees some plays with some of these adjustments as well. So interesting change that they did make there with Ebony Maw. We can expect him to maybe get thrown into some future decks. All right, next one, guys, we have Ghost Rider has been nerfed for us. So Ghost Rider has just been seeing a ton of play lately, and because of this early curve that you can really push out some raw power with Lady Sif and Ghost Rider, chopping up the Infinite, you know, Odin, anything that can drop some power early and really continue your turns later into the game. So made the adjustment of Ghost Rider going from 3 mana to now 4 mana. So with that adjustment, I still believe he is a good card and will get played often, but having that 4 mana instead may make some needed adjustments to some decks out there just to ensure we are, you know, going through the curve in our decks. So again, we'll likely continue to see play, but we'll probably need some adjustments to make this combo continue to happen. So interesting one there. I am going to miss playing a Ghost Rider out early, as he does offer quite a bit for our gameplay. So we will see how that decides to go as we move on. Kazar, not much of a difference here. Essentially, he has gone from 4 mana, 5 power to now 4 mana, 4 power. So our developers were really just seeing a lot of this zoo variant get maybe a little out of hand. So nerfed his initial power to maybe tiered, you know, tone down that very strong onslaught that can come from playing these, you know, very heavy one drop decks. So Kazar nerf is pretty slight, but I don't know how much of an adjustment they will make there, but something we'll kind of check out in the future. So next one is pretty interesting if I can type. Sorry about that. Okay. Okoye. So Okoye was nerfed in the, well, nerfed slash buffed in our most recent patch. She was initially a 2-mana, 1-power creature with the ability of buffing everything in her deck plus 2. They decided to change her to a 1-cost, 1-mana, 1-power, but the fact that she was such low cost, she was thrown in pretty much every single deck out there, so they made another adjustment on this particular character, and now she is a 2-mana, 2-power, and buffing up our deck plus 1-power. So hopefully this will be the last change we see for Okoye. I know she was seeing a lot of play at the very initial launch with the ability of plus 2-power to the deck. Moving her down to the 1-mana just made her, you know, an easy entry for anyone. Now at this 2-mana, 2-power, we might see some adjustments, and she might not be in every single deck going forward. So we'll see how that adjustment kind of goes. With her giving a lot of power into the decks, I imagine she'll stick around. Scarlet Witch is our next one on the list. So as you guys can tell, we got quite a bit of changes. I appreciate you guys tuning in this long. I know we're doing something a little different, so let me know what you think down in the comment section about these emergency meetings on these patch notes. So Scarlet Witch, she's been adjusted from 1-mana to 2-mana. She, a lot of the times for these games, was just too much consistency of being able to switch zones that we didn't like, and our developers did want to see some adjustments there, so we have to play around that a little bit more, and it is a little tougher now with Scarlet Witch being 2-mana. So we might not see her as much as an easy entry. I know we just had the Mindscape as the featured zone, so might be a little harder to make those adjustments, but still being 2-mana, I believe, will still positively affect our gameplay. Scorpion's probably one of my favorite updates that they made in this one. So originally a 3-mana, 3-power, now being adjusted to a 2-mana, 2-power. So I believe they thought it would be a little too strong to keep him in that 3-power range, but knocking him down to 2-mana, I believe, is going to help his entry into some decks. Especially if we're able to buff him up a little bit with like Okoye and Nakia. Might see some play in a Lockjaw deck as well. I know we've played him on our Good Boy and our Dog Pound deck. So a lot of fun that you can have a Scorpion. And I think this adjustment was a pretty wise one for the overall consistency of that negative one ability. So Strong Guy. Man, I just started my Sarah Storm deck. I just got Sarah and was having some fun with Strong Guy, but did make some pretty big adjustments here. So initially, before this patch, Strong Guy was a 2-mana, 3-power guy. He is now a 4-mana, 4-power guy. So this guy, the Strong Guy, 4-power guy now, 4-mana guy. Anyways. So Strong Guy having this adjustment is going to be pretty significant. A lot of the times these, you know, drop your hand on turn 5, turn 6, turn 7 relied on Strong Guys with the likes of Hell Cows and Lady Sifs in order to discard our hand all the way out while also playing out Strong Guy at that same turn. So the fact that he's going up to 4-mana, I believe he's going to get cut from a lot of decks. He might be a little stronger himself being 4-power and can get up to 10 with his plus 6 ability. Only time will tell here. I think those big adjustments in mana consistencies is going to make him a lot tougher to involve in a lot of those entry level decks. So we'll see how Strong Guy kind of affects the metagame, but I believe this is probably one of the most significant changes, in my opinion, that we saw in this particular patch. So a little bit of an interesting one. We'll see how much this is affected. All right, guys, just a few more here. We are seeing a little bit of an adjustment for Jubilee. So on reveal, play a card from your deck at this location rather than the top card of our deck. So the fact that Jubilee was pretty much always getting America Chavez is something that the developers felt was too consistent for 4-mana rocking 11-power at a location. So made the adjustment to be any card from our deck, so we might see Jubilee drop just a little bit, but the fact that she is still bringing so much power potentially when she's pulling something means you might see some other high value cards. The Big Bodacious Creatures deck in some of my previous videos would be one such deck I still believe Jubilee will do really, really well in. Lastly, the other ones we got Hulkbuster we're going to take a look at. So Hulkbuster, not much of a difference, but really the change here is his mana cost. The 3 mana does not add into the creature that he joins. So if you put him on a multiple man and then, you know, get moved around by a Magneto normally, that doesn't happen anymore, or that will start to happen, but previously this mana cost was added to that creature when it was joined, so a little bit of an adjustment. Our other two adjustments, Killmonger and Sandman, will be joining some of the earlier pools, and I really like this change from the developers just because a lot of the times as we were reaching this pool 3, our really essentially Killmonger would stop a lot of these heavy one drop decks, you know, storm out the board last turn. And Killmonger being an early pool entry, I do feel is going to be a huge change as everyone's going to have access to this. So I really think the game is going to start switching to a more mid-range style deck just because of that. Sandman being the second one, so again, kind of stopping that storm everything out, really combos against the Sarah decks out there looking to just drop their hand on the last turn of the game. So Sandman being available earlier on may help, you know, alleviate some of that pressure. I do hope Sandman gets a little bit of a buff to his power, as that one power does not affect too much for him, but not too bad at the very least. But that is what we are looking at today, guys. We're going to head on over to the Nexus event section here next, so stay tuned. We'll see you real soon. All right, guys, taking a look at our Nexus event here. So taking a look, we are going to be checking out the two featured characters for this particular Nexus event, also giving you a breakdown of what this Nexus event involves and how we can utilize our gold to better impact what we're looking to get out of this Nexus event. So firstly, we will take a look at Jane Foster, the Mighty Thor. So Jane Foster is a 5-mana, 8-power character with the on-reveal effect of draw all cards from our deck that cost 0. So if you can think, we just had Thor into the game, which is a 4-mana, 6-power guy who throws Mjolnir into our deck. Mjolnir being a 0-mana card allows us to pull it with Jane Foster. So I think we're going to see some sweet combos with the two Thors in Marvel Snap, and I'm going to be trying Lockjaw, something, a variation of that, in order to utilize this sweet combo. So we'll see how that goes as we're getting into it. But for this Nexus event, we're going to be opening as many as we can so we can see what happens when we unlock the Destroyer. So we already have the Destroyer in the game, but the fact that he's in here still, we're curious to see what that's going to look like. So stay tuned. We're going to be opening up as many as we can in order to see what happens in this breakdown. So let's get you over to the individual Nexus event notes so you can get a better understanding of what to expect here. So let's get over there. All right, guys. So initially, when we click on the info button on the Nexus event, we get this very cool entry. So this is just kind of showcasing what we are looking at in this Nexus event, everything that we can unlock. Really like this Jane Foster. I think that's going to be a cool addition. A lot of these sweet new avatars, which I really like. This Destroyer one right here looks sweet. So hopefully we can get that. I think that'd be really cool. Also can get the card variant as well right here. And then Mantis, I think, is maybe my favorite one alongside Groot. Kind of sad we didn't see a Gamora one, but maybe that'll come in the future. So maybe it was just dealing with the movie a little bit more. We didn't see Gamora in the movie, but I didn't say that. All right, so let's get you over. Test Your Might, Nexus event, featured characters. So looking at that awesome Jane Foster, the Mighty Thor art, on reveal drawing all the cards in there. The Destroyer, I think this is actually a bug. This is 18 power now, not 16, but not too bad. cool, the Jane Foster variants, and there's that sweet Destroyer one. So that'd be awesome if we can get that one. Don't play Destroyer all that often, but that variant might make it so I might have to. So keep in mind there's some fine text in here as well. After global launch, Nexus Event, super rare variants are limited to the Nexus Event they are released within and potentially may not be available to be earned again in the future. So it's looking like it's trying to remain consistent with, what you earn is going to be special. So the fact that the Nexus Events are giving some special variants and avatars and such make it a little bit more custom to you, which I know is something they were really striving for with this collection. So some other ones, we got Rockets. I do like Rockets there, pretty cool. Drax, oh man, Drax, I wish you were a little bit better. Mantis, not too bad. I like this one. I kind of like the color scheme and that black and white striking off with the green. Groot one's pretty cool. You can actually, didn't see that the first time through, but Rocket Raccoon is looking on there in his variant. This a very handsome Star-Lord there, so very cool. Good looking avatars, as we mentioned. Quite a few in here, so very nice. So, limited event details. All right, so test your might during this event. We want to utilize this limited time event for base card, the Mighty Jane Foster, and Destroyer will be opening when we utilize this Nexus event. So in most cases, the base probability of all characters is evenly distributed, so we'll get the breakdown of what that looks like. The general rules, each event could be opened up 200 times, so we'll price that out as that will be quite a bit in gold. So within 200 openings, the player is guaranteed to receive all super rare and rare event rewards. So if you're one of a completionist, you do have the means to get everything in this pack if you so desire. Each time you open a Nexus event, you have a 1.5% chance to earn a super rare reward. You are guaranteed to win a super rare reward of at least once per 50 attempts. So guaranteed at least four of the super rare stuff. And of course, if you're unlocking everything, you'll get it all in one go as well. So does pretty much give you 50% chance to receive one of these super rare characters. We'll see how that ends up when we open a Destroyer in there. So if you already have a base card, it is removed from the pool, which is what we were looking to see. So potential rewards. So once a super reward are earned, no more super rewards can be earned from that particular Nexus event. So pretty nice throw in right there. Weren't really expecting what was going to happen with that Destroyer being in there, but that does at least even the chances of us getting something we are looking for. So again, rare rewards. Probability is 9.5, guaranteed to win a rare reward or better at least once per 10 attempts. So we'll get to some of the openings so you can kind of see what that looks like. If you're interested in a more detailed, breakdown of what that gold looks like, I would be more than happy to kind of get that mathed out for you. So, sorry about that. Price and gold are earned. So to give you more opportunities for the Nexus events, we'll have increased amount of free gold in each season, 2,000 gold in total. So again, hoping to kind of buff that up a little bit more. Here is that base percentage for each one. Jane Foster, you got the Destroyer as our base cards and the sweet variants that they offer as well. And then the base probability at 9.5 for our rares, all those really cool variants that you were seeing, those base avatars. And then your credits, boosters, that kind of stuff. All right, guys, we got the last bit of our video. We are opening up our Nexus event packs. Let's see what this looks like. We got quite a bit of gold saved up, so we're just going to start opening away here. Purchase our rifts. Okay, starting off with some credits. Sunspot boosters, Agent 13 boosters, some more credits, 30 Invisible Woman boosters, some 20 Leech boosters, 300 credits, and there is our first variant in Groot. So on reveal, opponent played a card here, plus 3 power. So interesting way it's laid out. So it really looks like you're really only going to get the best of what you're looking for on that last 10th opening, essentially. So let's keep going. So great way to earn credits and boosters. So if you're looking for ways to really max out your credit efficiency, these Nexus events looks to be the way to do it. Groot, 200 credits. Wow, 40 Leech boosters, 20 Mr. Sinister, ooh, and Jane Foster, the Mighty Thor, as an avatar. So not too bad, but we do want to actually have the card, right? So let's keep going. Some more credits, boosters, strong guy, credits. Oh my goodness, those credits though. Infinaut and Star-Lord avatar. And we keep going and going and going. Heimdall. Interesting. So we might see something where they add, you know, like a effect when you open these. It is a little nonchalant so far, but we're gonna keep going. Oh, we gotta get some more gold. So we'll be right back, guys. All right, guys, we're gonna keep going. We got some more gold. We are replenished. Let's go ahead and continue our openings. Looking at 30 claws. Oh, that was not from the openings. That was from the gold. Don't think you're gonna get that much. That'd be nice. That'd be the jackpot. 200 credits, 220 Mantis, 300 credits, Lockjaw, 300 credits, and the Rocket Avatar, 200 credits, 30 Omega Red, 200 credits. Oh my goodness. So collection level is really gonna start going up with the fact that we have so much credits from these Nexus openings. Let's keep going. We want, oh, I thought we were getting it right there. We got Star-Lord variant, cool. So I don't play Star-Lord too often. It's unfortunate that these sweet variants are for some of the Guardians that don't really see that much play right now. Cool Drax, Double Dino, 400 credits, 200 credits. Yeah, we got that sweet, the Thor version of the Destroyer, I suppose. So cool looking avatar. And heck yeah, we got the avatar, or excuse me, the card variant too. So nice combo. So we'll probably be having a Destroyer deck here real soon for you guys. Man, we want Jane though. Give us Jane. 200 credits. Angela, Ghost Rider, 200 credits. Dr. Doom, 40 claw, oh my goodness. 200 credits, the Groot avatar, and the Mantis avatar, wave. So far, this is interesting, guys. I am very hopeful that we're gonna get Jane Foster, right? There's some more credits, Sentinels, credits again, Infinaut, and there's Drax. All right, Drax variant, sure. Mantis variant, sure. Oh my gosh, guys. Yeah, I spent a lot of gold there. Hopefully we can get some more gold throughout the rest of this Nexus event. It does run 1 week and 6 days, but we are gonna stop there, guys. I can't justify it myself to keep working towards that card, the Jane Foster. She looks awesome, but the fact that it is going to be a pretty random chance to get there is going to equivalent to a lot of gold. So be careful out there. That's what we're realizing with this Nexus event, in my opinion, but can potentially be a lot of fun, and especially for those of you who really want to have this card, you can go out there and get it. But for those of us that do want to hold off, don't want to, you know, spend all of our gold, if we got to maintain a good level there. So keep that in mind. You know, overall, we're interested in this Nexus event. I think it offers a lot of potential with the fact that we're able to unlock some cards potentially and those cool avatars and whatnot. But keep in mind, you know, we want to make sure, you know, is the variance valuable enough to justify opening these Nexus events as much as possible? So keep that in mind while you're working towards this Nexus event goal, guys. And overall, I know it's going to be a lot more of a longer video, so if you stuck around this far, thank you. Please like and subscribe for more. We're going to end this one for today, but we'll be coming back real soon to give you some more Marvel Snap content and give you some of our first deck techs after this most recent patch. So stay tuned, guys. We'll see you next time.